How to fill out our sizing kit. Make sure it covers your entire nail. Please size both hands. Need somewhere to get cheap nail supplies from? Why I began selling press-on nails. After COVID hit, my parents were getting just enough to pay the rent. However, my mom kept buying me nail supplies because she supports my passion for nails. I felt bad when she came home with new things because I knew they were going through a tough time financially. I knew I couldn't sit at home all day doing nothing while my parents work their $1 off so my brother and I can have a roof over our head. I saw a TikTok of a girl that showed how she makes and sells press on nails online, and I thought to myself, if she can do it, so can I. The only issue was that I didn't have spare money to buy the supplies I needed to begin a press on nail business, so I sold some things on OfferUp until I finally got the money to begin. I started doing some sets and putting them on Etsy. I wasn't getting any sales and I was about to give up until one of you guys bought my first set, and that gave me motivation to keep going.
Here's all the basic stuff you need to start a press-on nail business. First, you're gonna need some nail stands. I used the fun tack mounting tabs to put the tips on there. And of course, you're gonna need some false nail tips. I got this from Amazon, and this is what I used for my shaped long coffin. Then you're gonna need everything for your prepping kit. A wooden cuticle tip, nail glues, mini files, mini buffer, and an alcohol wipe. Mine also comes with an instruction card. Then you're gonna need boxes to put in your actual nails in. I got 100 of these boxes for $44 on Amazon. You can definitely find something more affordable. I just thought these boxes were really pretty. Of course, you need your gel polishes, a UV LED lamp, your basic files and buffers, a heavy-duty double-sided tape to attach your nails to the boxes, cardstock paper for sizing kits, and finally, bubble mailers.
So today I set out to create the world's most expensive set of nails. Our friends over at Core Gem sourced a bunch of stuff for us. The package included a bunch of colored sapphires, rubies, and this amazing pear-shaped canary diamond. I was really scared to start. My main issue was trying to make sure that I got the most brilliance out of the stones. Normally what I use is Swarovski, and it has a foil backing, which helps the stone sparkle. But these are some highfalutin, bare-naked little buddies. I devised this clever plan to manually paint a silver setting underneath each of the stones that I mounted. These took like 3.5 hours, and this was only one hand. And I know you all are wondering what the price tag is, and yes, you can order them at the link in my bio. Like all of our nails, they are reusable for the price of $10,000. Made it.
Drop the roof and let the smoke clear. I got diamonds, the winter sea slides in both ears. Dice rolling on the...
So this drawer is where I keep most of my press-on nail supplies. So at the front, I've got all of my cuticle sticks, nail glues, and nail files, which all go into every prep kit for every set. Then behind that, I've got a load of prep wipes, which also go into every prep kit, and a sweep, which goes into every order. I've got a tape measure for measuring nail tips, some holographic bags, which I obviously put the nails in, and then some little clear plastic bags, which I put spare nails in. Behind that, I've got some mesh bags for all the packaging.
Feeling like this. Oh, why? Love it while grabbing the rhythm, your hips. That's right. Rhythm is a dancer. I need a companion. Girl, I guess that must be you. Body like the summer. Fuck you like no other. Don't you tell them what we do.
Here's a few items to get you started with your own nail press-on business. So all my tips that I first started, I got from Amazon, but you can also find shops on Etsy. These are all polishes you can find on Amazon, tack for your nail stands, polishes that I love to use, nail files, and buffers.